Hi, my name is Mike and I'm an application support engineer with Agilent. This short video will describe the crest factor considerations you need to be aware of when measuring AC signals. A true RMS responding DMM actually measures the heating potential of an applied voltage. Is used to determine the power dissipated in a resistor, and that power is proportional to the square of the measured true RMS voltage. And this is independent of wave shape, and that's why this technique is used so widely. It's very flexible. You do not have to have just a sine wave. You can measure many different types of wave shapes. Now here's an example of a fairly unique wave shape with very high frequency content in the spike. Now even though we can use the true RMS technique to measure this wave shape, we need to degrade the specification because of this high frequency energy. This technique cannot capture high frequency energy as well as the lower frequency energy. So what crest factor is a figure of merit that describes the wave shape. And it basically is the ratio of the peak value of the waveform to the RMS value of the waveform. We have a couple examples here to the left of some common wave shapes. The sine wave has a crest factor of 1.414. The ramp or the triangle waveform has a crest factor of 1.732. And for a pulse train, depending upon the duty cycle, you can calculate its crest factor. So a rule of thumb for you to remember is basically the greater the crest factor, the greater the energy content and the higher frequency harmonics. We have a section of the 34401A DMM spec here that talks about crest factor, and you can see the maximum that the 34401A can measure would be a crest factor of 5. And this is very typical across the industry for true RMS responding DMMs. Because it degrades with increasing crest factor, you need to add this additional error of percent of reading if you do not have a sine wave input. The 34410 and 34411 DMMs actually use a slightly different technique. Instead of using the thermal conversion, they actually do digital sampling. So they're basically digitizing the incoming waveform, and then they do a true RMS calculation. This technique allows crest factors of up to 10 and is basically only limited by the peak input and the bandwidth of the DMM. This is a unique technique, and most DMMs do not use this technique in the industry. So this concludes this short video of crest factor considerations you need to be aware of when measuring AC signals.